It's an emotional, inspirational, and yet thought-provoking track. Yeah, I started working with Winky D like over 20 years ago. I think we both come from a reggae dancehall sound system background, and reggae dancehall music has always been like a mouthpiece for society. So Zimbabwe, was so easy for us to put together because the vision is something that's been with us the past 20 years in terms of talking about anything that affects society in a negative way, speaking out for on behalf of the voiceless. Yeah, I first met Shingai also over 10 years ago. She's somebody who represents Zimbabwe to the core, represents Africanness to the core, and having some smash big records internationally, she's kept true to where she comes from. She's never strayed from that and always made sure at any point she can get, she represents Zimbabwe in the best way. When Winky reached out to me for us to work on this track, she was the perfect fit for that. You know, what we have today is a result of those two powerful individuals who love to represent Zimbabweans in its purity, coming together to create this beautiful piece. Winky D is a great producer. A lot of people don't understand that a producer can sometimes be the person who doesn't even play any instruments, but has the vision and has the idea to bring certain elements together to create something. That's the main core job of a producer, is to be able to understand what needs to be done for an idea to come out in a certain way. And Winky D did exactly that here. He managed to get myself to create the canvas, me or Skid and Kelvin, the canvas, so the blank page. And him and Shingai were able to then paint on that page. And we have the masterpiece that is Zimbabwe, today. That ability to produce also comes with being able to relate to the people you're working with in the best way. So you should be able to articulate and say your vision in a few words. Make sure everyone who's involved understands. And I think when I look at some of the comments today, after the track has been released, a lot of people agree that this is an emotional, but at the same time, inspirational track that they can dance to. So there's three elements that were included there. As African people, naturally, even when we're going through anything bad or sad, we still dance and sing. That is our African culture, that's our tradition. That's the way of our people. And this track, even though it is emotional, it is asking some very difficult, hard questions. It's actually got a rhythm to it. And I think that's what Winky wanted, or at least that's what I understood from the vision. When I got the creative brief, I wanted to include something that had identity in it. So if you listen very carefully, you can hear some of the elements that I've used in there and some electric jazz guitar, which is common in a lot of music that we identify with Zimbabwe. I've had the pleasure of working with Walshy Fire from Major Lazer. And one thing Major Lazer does really well is being able to fuse different genres, including some EDM elements, electronic dance music elements, and some orchestral elements, which really help bring out the emotion in the track. In Journey, I think we have a total of about four or five different versions that we did before we got to the end point, including some guitars from Kelvin and some beautiful additional production and engineering from Skip as well. So a massive team effort to bring out this work of art. Yeah, with Zimbabwe, I hope people really get inspired and maybe through their day-to-day life start answering the questions. You know, is this the land that we cried for? Is this the land that we died for? And what are we doing for the upcoming generations? You know, and make sure that any dialogue that we have doesn't turn into a fallacy, doesn't turn into a joke thing. That we have dialogue with purpose moving forward as one people. Because no one is coming to save us. It's up to us as Zimbabweans to come together. And I think that's what I got. That's my interpretation of this musical piece and the purpose it was serving. Is to unite ourselves by asking these hard questions so that we can thought-provoking and encourage some sort of dialogue.